Yes, please, I have a second question.
Second question, okay, brother.
Yeah, there's one thing in the religion that when you are a non-Christian and you want to marry a Muslim woman, it is said that you ought to switch your religion before you can get married to the woman. So why is it so?
Brother asked the question that if a Christian man wants to marry a Muslim woman, he has to change the religion. Today morning in Accra, I was asked that when a Christian woman marries a Muslim man, the Christian woman need not change of religion, correct? This is what the question was. Because the verse of the Quran says in Surah Maidah chapter 5, verse number 5, lawful for you from this day are the women of Ahle Kitab in marriage. When a Christian woman marries a Muslim man, whatever she believes in all the prophets from Adam, peace be upon him, till Jesus, peace be upon him, the Muslims believe in them all. So all the prophets who she believes in, she does not have to reject any. And the Muslims respect all the prophets. But when a Muslim girl marries a Christian man, the Muslims believe in Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him also, and the Christians don't believe. So that means when she marries in a family of Christianity, they do not believe in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so she will not be comfortable. But according to me, the Quran says in Surah Baqarah chapter number 2, verse number 221, it says that do not marry unbelieving women until they believe. A believing woman who's a slave woman is far superior than an unbelieving woman, even if she allows you. So you cannot marry a non-Muslim until she becomes a Muslim. And according to me, it's also mentioned in the Quran in Surah Maidah chapter 5, verse number 72. Lakat kafra lazina kalu inna laha huwal masih ibn marima. They are doing kufr, they are blaspheming. Those who say that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is Allah. That means the Quran says, many Christians say Jesus is God. It's kufr, it's blaspheming. That means one place the Quran says you can marry the girl from the Ahle Kitab, Jew or a Christian. One place says you cannot marry a mushrik, one who worships somebody else as God. Chapter 5, verse 72 says the Christians say that Jesus is God with his shirk. Who can you marry? The reply is given in Surah Imran, chapter 3, verse 110. That woman Ahle Kitab, lakana khair allahum. Min humul mu'minuna wa aksarumul fasikun. If the people of the book had faith, it would have been better for them. Among them, there are some who are believers, they are mu'min, but the majority are perverted transgressors. That means you can only marry those Christians who believe in one God, not the Christian girls who believe in three in one, who believe Jesus is God. It is wrong. You can only marry those Christians who believe God is one and does not believe Jesus is God, who believe Jesus is the messenger of God. Brother, I would like to ask you.
But is it possible that a non-Christian would marry a Muslim?
It's not permitted. A Christian cannot marry a Muslim because the Christian believes Jesus is God. It is shirk. It is the biggest sin in Islam. Allah says in Surah Maryam, chapter number 19, verse number 88 to 92. وَقَالَ اتَّخَذُ الرَّحْمَانُ وَلَدًا. And they say, Allah most gracious has begotten a son. لَقَدْ جِيْتُمْ شَيْئًا إِدَّا. Indeed, they have put forth a thing most monstrous. Anyone says that Allah has begotten a son, it is the biggest abuse you can give to Almighty God. فَقَالُوا اتَّخَذُ الرَّحْمَنُ وَلَدًا لَقَدْ جِيْتُمْ شَيْئًا إِدَّا تَقَادُ السَّمَوَاتُ يَتَفَطَّرْنَ مِنْهُ. If the sky had feeling, the sky would have burst open. فَتَنشَقُّ الْأَرْضُ. The earth would have split open. وَتَخِرُّ الْجِبَالُ هَدًّا. And the mountains would have fallen down to utter ruin. If anyone says that Allah has begotten a son, it is the biggest abuse you can give to Allah. The sky would split open. The earth would have split open. The mountains would fall down to utter ruin. That's the reason anyone who says Jesus is God, it is shirk. It is prohibited. It's a sin. That's the reason no Christian can marry a Muslim. Any Christian who says Jesus is God, you cannot marry. But if the Christian girl says that Jesus is not God, the messenger of God, and she believes in one God, then no problem. Hope that answers the question. Brother, do you believe there is one God?
Sure.
Do you believe Jesus is God?
No.
MashaAllah. Do you believe Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God?
Yes.
MashaAllah. That means you're a Muslim. If you believe that God is one, and if you believe Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God, these are the minimum two things required for a person to enter into the fold of Islam. Would you like to say it in Arabic? Would you like to say it in Arabic? What do you say in English? That there's no one worthy of worship except God, except Allah, and that Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. Would you like to say it in Arabic?
Yes.
Anyone is forcing you?
No.
You're doing it of your own free will?
Yes.
Okay, I'll say it in Arabic and you repeat it. Ashadu.
Ashadu.
Allah.
Allah.
Ilaha.
Ilaha.
Illallah.
Illallah.
Wa ashadu.
Wal ashadu.
Anna.
Anna.
Muhammadan.
Muhammadal.
Abduhu.
Abdul.
Wa rasuluhu.
Wa rasuluhu.
I bear witness.
I bear witness.
There is none worthy of worship.
There is none worthy of worship.
Except Allah.
Except Allah.
And I bear witness.
And I bear witness.
That Prophet Muhammad.
That Prophet Muhammad.
Is the messenger.
Is the messenger.
And servant of Allah.
And servant of Allah.
MashaAllah, you have become a Muslim and may Allah, inshallah, grant you Jannah. May you grant you paradise. May you get the best in this world and the Akhirah. I would like to give you a copy of the translation of the Quran. Can you come, please, on the stage?